That's right.
I don't like to get a God business like that, but I love him.
Come on now.
So Eden goes strength in Abraham, the book says he visited Sarah.
Yes. Yes.
And God did unto Sarah.
Amen. Yes.
What he promised.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I ain't trying to discuss with y'all what God did. But the Bible says, oh.
Come on.
In all the great church.
Yes.
Try the church right around the
corner. Yes.
I'm trying to show you the power of God.
That's
and
right.
God going to live by our standards.
Amen.
When God released the word, he didn't turn half over to make sure it happens.
Yes.
And just because you get old or sick or broke, it doesn't want to change it.
Right.
All you need to do is believe it.
Yes.
Oh, you want to hear me?
Yes.
He might have to touch somebody else. If your promise comes to pass, it doesn't mean he forgot you. It means he's going to do whatever is necessary. At the point in time, God do stuff that church folk can't stand. At the point of church folk can tell you, that's not God.
Yes.
He'll do whatever he got to do.
Yes, he will.
Right?
Yes, he will.
I am a Jose. Por lo que está Dios. So we're under the law of grace. I'm happy to
God. Yes.
And God released the word. What devil is going to stop that?
My God, my God.
What witch mm-hmm. is going to stop that?
None.
Particularly, Pat, when you're about an apostolic ministry.
Yes.
Amen.
What witch is that on this earth that's stronger than God's apostles?
None.
Y'all ain't talking. See, we believe the wrong way. Y'all remember when people come to church, oh, that's a witch, everybody gets scared.
Yeah.
No, we don't do that here.
Come on.
But God releases a word.
Amen.
That's what I'm not going to move much further because we got started late. The law of grace is connected directly to God's word.
Yes.
Because grace is his ministry. Whose report do you believe?
Lord.
You believe what you see, how you feel, and what they say?
God.
Or you can believe what God said.
Amen. Amen.
And sometimes the apostle, he try to turn you into this little drone.
Yep.
This self-righteous person with no power.
Yep.
Y'all ain't talking back to me.
Yes.
And the people God be trying to use, they rejected the church.
Yes.
They're full of Holy Ghost, they're full of power. The church don't want them to do with them, but they ain't dressed right.
Yes.
If you know them, please send them over here. We receive them with gladness and walk them through the process and let the Lord use them right in what they in. Because sometimes they got to be at the club to minister to somebody at the club. Before I said to a Jew, I became a Jew. Yeah. So stop telling people that not to go tell the witness when they
That's
get
right.
That's
right.
That's
right.
So now, Chanda!
Amen.
Oh, I'm so blessed, y'all. I'm going to start preaching.
Glory. Come on.
I'm so blessed. God has changed the season of my life.
Preach.
The way he's even blowing my mind, I'm just getting started.
Oh,
you ain't hearing what I'm saying. But I'm just getting started, man. All the talk they did, I'm still here.
That's
all the things they said about my wife and I, we still married. I still have a good marriage. I'm still best friend. My God's been ready to bless her. You already bless her. We're going to play some favor, right? I'm talking to him here.
Yes.
That's right.
Amen.
After that, you faithfully do
it.
He'll come around and reward you
yes.
for everything they told you he wouldn't do. God will blow their mind. He said, I'm going to confirm the word of my servant.
Yes.
I perform the counsel of my messenger.
Yes.
But I want to tell somebody here, God is preparing a table before you. I don't know none of your business, but what if you tell you something that you don't think I know? In the presence of her family.
Yes.
Glory to God. Yes. I know I'm not in your business, but y'all know exactly what I'm talking about.
Yes.
And it's not possible that the devil can change that. I don't care how drunk you get.
Amen.
And listen, I got so high, I didn't even know where I was.
Amen.
And my wife was an expert. She could find me, man. I didn't even know where I was. Lord God. Yeah, she could find me. I didn't even know where I was. I couldn't figure that out. Somebody said that.
You go, Philip.
None of that testifying to somebody. All of that was used to get me with this conviction that I have concerning the things of God.
Amen.
Because if I'm going to the floor, I'm going to walk away from God. If I were to listen to some family members.
That's right.
Wow.
That's right. Come on now. Come on now. Don't go there. Don't go there.
I'm not talking about family members. He said, all right. If I were to listen to the voices that I heard, if she would have listened to the voices, what are you going to do with me on drugs? You already got six children. I was kind of busy in the world. Somebody said, no. And when God interrupted my life, I was already going to be a principal in a school. I had two choices. I could be a center director for Job Corps and principal in the school system. They were both fine for my attention because I couldn't keep both jobs. I had both jobs at the time. I was living good. But God interrupted my life ministry. And when he put me through the process of preparation, it didn't look good. I'm going to tell somebody.
Amen.
I don't care what you did last night. God's plan has not changed. I don't care what you battled with.
Amen.
I don't care what nobody said to you. God's plan for your life does not change.
That's
it's
right.
Eternal. You are talking back to me.
Amen.
I don't care what you think about yourself or how you feel about yourself. God's plan for your life is eternal. It's not going to change. I don't care how upset you get. I don't care how long you've been away from church. God's plan. I preach it. God's plan for your life is eternal.
That's it.
Yes, Jesus.
That is
why do you think Jesus ain't going to the temple and get the religious folks in
there?
He done got some people on the witness on the streets.
That's right.
The people who are the church folk ain't want nothing to do with, he done got them for his ministry.
Yes.
And I'm closing with this right now because I'm talking to about five or six of y'all in here right now. You anointed, you're grace, and you're confused on the church. Oh, God, help me here.
Amen.
And God sent you here to hear my voice this morning. To let you know that you're not off course. See, God is beginning in the name of Jesus. How you want to lead people? See, too many people want to go to school, apostle, and then get a crown. But a crown don't come but to a cross. And you only better revive me here. See, the problem putting a crown on somebody's head who's been crossed. The crown get too heavy for them. And they get full of pride. And they get full of themselves. And all of a sudden it's all about them. But when you understand why they were crossed, they remember where they was yesterday. So they can't judge you so much when you're in your mess. Somebody gotta talk to me here. I can cross, baby. I can't judge you. I don't care what you tell me. You can come here and do the ministry that God called you to do.
Yes.
Preach.
As I close. Am I helping you here a little bit?
Oh yes.
It's an eternal plan. When God released the word, I'm done. When he releases his word, you got his backing on that.
Amen.
That's up under the law of grace.
That's
it. Yeah, but we get in trouble with those things. We don't believe in that.
Yeah, that's right.
We have had so many games played on us in church. That we go to church thinking about who the preacher is and not focus on the Lord.
That's right.
Listen, I don't care how many weaknesses my preacher got. If I could hear God in him, that's all I'm concerned about. Moses, fried chicken, french fries, mashed potato, coleslaw.